Hello, I'm Sergio Pablos, director of Klaus, and with me is Edgar Martins, head of story. We thought it'd be interesting to show some of the stuff that actually did not make it into the final cut of the film. Finding the story is a long process. We try a lot of things and not all of it works, and sometimes we are shocked to find out a lot of things that we thought were for sure going to be in the movie end up not being in the movie.
This is what we are looking at, our animatics, which means it's not the final quality of the film. These are very rough boards. I mean, some of them are not that rough, especially Sergio's boards are not that rough. Trying out drawing expression and camera position to see if the sequence works.
And some of those changes are big. Like in some cases, we actually had to change the whole story.
This is Isikstoel. Ah, yes.
This was our original opening for the film. And it wasn't just the original opening, it was the original main character, which was actually very different. It was still Jesper, but he was not the son of a wealthy postmaster.
This is not
general.
The spoiled kid. No. This is the opposite.
This was, we thought, how about this is somebody who has nothing and whose life has beaten down where he never had a chance. And it was quite a shock to find out when we played the first version of the film altogether. It's like, it doesn't work.
Man, do you remember the day I still remember when you had that moment of clarity where we need to change the whole beginning of the film.
We thought it'd be interesting for you to take a look at what we started with and what made us change our minds, essentially, right? So enjoy.
I've come down all sorts of chimneys in my life. Some are wide and easy to go through. Some are long and narrow. Some are straight. Some have twists and turns. Oh yes, I've come down many, many chimneys. And you want to know what made it all worthwhile? Absolutely nothing.
Again, Jesper.
Of course it did.
Brushes!
No, wait! They say the only thing darker than a chimney sweep's skin is his future. Hilarious. This is Isikstoel. Ah, yes. It was a land of opportunity, a time of prosperity. But not for everyone. Nope. If you happen to be born in the wrong place, none of it was meant for you. You can say all you want about playing the hand you're dealt, but let me just tell you, some people get all the cards, and others, well, others don't even get to sit at the table. And how did I cope with it all, you might ask? Aw, are you hungry, little fella? Here you go. Come here. Wait, where are you going? You don't want it? Suit yourself. Okay, so maybe I wasn't the paradigm of virtue. But in my defense, sometimes it almost seemed like someone up there was having way too much fun at my expense.
Good one.
I mean, come on. Life is supposed to have ups and downs, right? Well, trust me on this. I was way overdue for an up.
Oh, a guy is coming down the chimney. Oh, Santa Claus, of course. And then this skinny guy, completely bitter with life, appears on the chimney. I missed that shot just because it kind of, one shot introduced the whole universe of the film and the tone. So that one I miss as a concept.
I love what that shot was doing because it was very much encompassing the idea for the movie. You think this is going to be about Santa? Nope, it's about this guy.
The irony was all there.
Right. I missed that. And I think I missed that whole bitterness with the universe. Like he kept in that version, he kept looking up at the sky going, good one. You know, like there was someone up there. I missed that part of that.
That little moment where he is with the kitty and is about to feed him and then steals from him. I mean, that was like a good extreme for the character, you know?
That was really defining him. Supposed to be the character defining moment where you go, you think this guy's nice? Well, not really, you know?
Hello, guys? I'm stuck.
Okay, boys, it's quitting time.
Let's call it a day.
Hello? Guys? Hey, how about a hand here? They'll come back. They'll notice I'm not in the wagon. And they'll come back. Definitely they'll come
back. The idea was Jesper, the chimney sweep, happened to get stuck inside of a chimney and overheard a conversation where we're trying to find someone, one single postman to take the job of going to this tunnel up north and taking over the postal service over there, and no one wanted the job.
Hello? Hey! Up here!
You three have been personally handpicked by me.
Hello? Hello?
Describe as a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Here's what's in store for the lucky volunteer. A promotion to Officer of the Royal Postal Service, complete with all the perks.
Does that mean he gets his very own luxury apartment at the officer's residence with the indoor pool, the massage parlor, and the mint on the pillow? Huh? And unlimited access to galas, feasts, and shindigs?
And the postmaster was offering all kinds of perks to whoever took the job, and it was Jesper's, you know, dream of a life. Like, I get all those things if I take that job.
All you have to do in return is take over the Smearensburg post office until the end of the year and process a measly 10,000 letters through. What do you say, boys?
Say I'd rather be strung up.
Upside down.
By the big toes.
What?
Let's say 8,000 letters, huh? Who's up? 6,000 letters! It's a steal! Going once, going twice!
If that'll be all, Postmaster General, sir.
Walk out that door and you're all fired!
Still a more appealing option.
It's hopeless.
Well, relax and think it over during the holiday break.
No, no one goes until that's dealt with.
What?
I'll settle for anyone who'll take this job. Anyone!
Me! I'll take it!
He volunteers for the job, and they basically said, okay, fine, we got this sucker, send him up there. He's gonna fail, but, you know, we did our job, right? It was bureaucrats, essentially, sent it up there.
They processed him.
Right,
you know?
And this clip is about how he gets processed and sent out.
My up. My chance to escape this life of misery and soot. See you later, suckers.
A really nice contrast between him being possessed, going through all that, and then in the end being all happy, you know?
Right.
He didn't care of how he was being treated.
This guy's life sucks so bad that this is actually a step up for him. There's that mean Jesper again, where he looks over his shoulder at his fellow chimney sweep and goes, goodbye, suckers. He had a long way to travel to become a good guy. It was hard to like this guy.
It was hard. Yeah. I mean, you have fun with him, right?
Right.
But it's like, keep away.
Right. Plan was, we're going to like him because he's poor and poor guy, right? Yeah. But we're going to see that he's actually not nice about being being that. So, but it was a middle ground. It was like, we didn't know how to feel about him. Because, but also in the end, you could never get past the point where if his life was so horrible back home and the new life in Smears was even worse, why don't he just quit and go back? And he's got nothing to lose by going back, right? Yeah. This was not the right character to learn the lesson of altruism.
We ended up with a much nice arc for the character, more contrast, so.
Yeah, there's things I miss. In every one of these sequences, there's something that I go, too bad we couldn't make that work.